just try. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Dr. Dan Kraus. I am the clinic director of Terrapin Care Center here in College Park, Maryland. Welcome to our Facebook Live Knee Pain Seminar. We are a multidisciplinary medical pain management clinic that focuses on keeping people away from surgery and off pain meds. We have many different techniques that we use to do this, and I'm going to be sharing those with you over the coming weeks. Today, we're talking about knee pain. I like to say that we handle knee pain at a high level, meaning that we have many different techniques to get rid of knee pain because there are lots of different types of knee pain, and the causes of knee pain vary greatly from person to person. Some of the equipment behind me is vitally important to be able to help people with knee pain at a high level. And the reason why I keep saying that is because I feel personally that many providers don't do everything they possibly can to help patients with knee pain. And it's very, very common, as you know. So before I really get into it, let me just show you what's behind me. Behind me, this is a Super C-Arm video fluoroscopy unit. Fancy term for a device that is used to use x-ray to guide injections into the joint. To my left here is a diagnostic ultrasound machine. This is another way for us to guide injections into the joint. We use it a little bit more here in this clinic for soft tissue, for ligaments, tendons, muscles, visualized trigger points, and other soft tissue problems when we do injections. My personal feeling is that if you're going to do an injection, you might as well know where the needle is going exactly. Even if you swear that you know that joint inside out and backwards, it cannot possibly hurt to see the injection going into the joint where it's supposed to. And we can also use it for other things as well, and I'm going to explain that to you. Knee pain. I would say 80% of the knee pain that comes through this office has an arthritic component that is contributing to the pain. The other 20% is nerve and soft tissue, okay? And unfortunately, a lot of times, we don't know if the nerve component or the soft tissue component is contributing to the knee pain until we eliminate the osteoarthritis component of the pain, all right? And the way we do that is we x-ray, we do weight-bearing standing x-rays first, because I wanna know when someone stands, what gravity is doing to those knees, okay? If someone's laying down and we take an x-ray, we might be able to see degeneration throughout the joint, but we're not gonna know, well, weight bearing, what does that do to the joint? So that's the first thing that we do. We'll review that and we'll see, okay, yeah, this person has osteoarthritis, either mild, moderate, or quite often severe. Then we can talk about our options. What do we wanna do? All too often, medical practitioners go straight to steroid. Now the problem with steroid is, it has serious effects on the body, right? And so it affects different people different ways, and if you're diabetic, it can be very, very serious. It can affect blood glucose. But if you put a steroid into the same joint over and over again, it can actually make arthritis worse. And so it's not an answer, and it's not a treatment for osteoarthritis. It's to reduce swelling and inflammation to be able to get range of motion in the knee back. And a lot of times they'll refer to physical therapy after that to improve strength and stability, which is great. But when someone has osteoarthritis, the problem is inside the joint. So if you're having weight-bearing issues, if your balance is off, that's a serious sign of a problem that's going on, okay? Whether it's arthritis or even some sort of neurological problem, it should not be ignored. So if you have balance issues, get in to see us. If you're not gonna come in to see us, go see somebody, because it should not be ignored. It can be a sign of a serious underlying condition, okay? So please, don't ignore balance issues. So, a lot of people want to know about knee braces. Before we start talking about the injections, I really want to talk about knee braces because I see these commercials all the time on television where they're going after Medicare beneficiaries and trying to get them to get the knee braces through the television, through the advertisement. These braces are supposed to be fit by a practitioner onto the patient to make sure that it actually works and it does what it's supposed to. This knee brace is different than this knee brace. One is an unloader for osteoarthritis that either pushes on the outside or the inside, and we don't know which way we want to push until we look at the weight-bearing x-rays. So these television commercials, they're just burning up patients' benefits on Medicare because you only get one of these knee braces every 3 to 5 years. So do me a favor, please don't get your knee braces off of those television commercials. They also have the same commercials for back braces, and it's the same problem. It's not the right brace for the condition. So we fit knee braces to patients when it's appropriate for the condition. So for osteoarthritis, if we can unload that knee and take gravity away, it makes our treatments more effective. The most common treatment that we do for osteoarthritis of the knee is something called viscose supplementation. Fancy word for gel injections, lubricant injections. I've even heard of them called chicken shots before. The whole idea, it's called hyaluronate acid. The whole idea with these visco injections is to get a lubricant inside the joint that binds to the cartilage that's there to create a protective layer so it stops the grinding of the osteoarthritis. Now, that sounds great. However, if you have tears in the cartilage or old surgeries, or if the capsule around the knee is compromised, that substance won't stay there. So we're not going to subject our patients to one injection a week for 5 weeks, which is the typical series for a visco supplementation series, unless we know that the stability of the joint is there and the substance is going to stay. So this is an extra step. And what we do, and we use this machine behind us, the video fluoroscopy, we do something called an arthrogram. An arthrogram is where we put a contrast inside the knee, and maybe we'll put a little steroid in there too to reduce swelling inflammation to start off. And then we hit the button on the video fluoro, and we say, okay, does the contrast stay? Does it stay inside the knee where it's supposed to, or does it leak out? If it leaks out, there's no reason for us to put the patient through a visco supplementation series because they're not going to benefit from them. And it makes no sense. So if your doctor is not doing an arthrogram prior to a visco series, and you've never had an arthrogram and you're wondering why you're not responding well to this type of care, that might be it. Now, those kind of patients, it limits our options. But one of the options we do have, I mean, aside from we refer to an orthopedic, you know, because they might need that, in conjunction, we can do something called radiofrequency ablation, RFA for short. Fancy way to say nerve block in the knee. But it uses radio frequencies to deaden the geniculate nerves in that area. It can last 2 to 3 years. We see lots of patients that have had total knee replacements that still have pain in their knee. And the pain's not coming from the joint anymore because the joint is gone. All right, it's been, you know, they're bionic now, it's been replaced. So what they're feeling is irritation on the nerves, or soft tissue pain. So when we do these nerve blocks, we get tremendous results. And most patients have never heard of this, they have no clue. The other thing is I'm astounded daily how many patients have never heard of visco supplementation. Gel injections, lubricant injections, they're all different brands. Hyalgan, Supars, Euflexa, Orthovis, Synvis, they're all slightly different. Some organic comes straight from the rooster comb, part of the rooster. Others are synthetic. So if a patient, even though it's rare, if they have an allergy to chicken, you know, we will go with the synthetic version as opposed to the organic. Much rather use the chicken. Derived if we can. One of the most important things people need to know is that you want to utilize the least invasive things first, all right? You want to graduate to more invasive things as needed, okay? You don't start off with surgery, all right? Once you do that, it's done, okay? In this clinic, we don't see emergency knee replacement patients. They don't walk through the door. Usually when someone is ready to do the knee replacement, they've had it up to here, and it's like they've tried everything else first. The one thing that really disturbs me when I talk to patients, and they say, well, I'd just rather get it taken care of now because I don't want to bother with all that. I just want to get the total knee replacement. The knee is the largest joint in the body. I mean, it's a very serious procedure. They've made incredible advancements in their ability to replace this joint. However, it is a substantial surgery with significant recovery. And if people vary, there are complications, there are infections, there are problems with the healing. So if you need it, you need it. But let's try the least invasive things first and then graduate to more invasive things as we go. I know it sounds common sense, but you'd be surprised how often in healthcare common sense is not followed. The other thing with the knee brace, which is really important, is that when I can fit the brace to the patient and it actually fits them properly, I won't let them leave this clinic unless it fits properly and I know they're gonna wear it. If they're not gonna wear it, I'm not giving it to you. I mean, that's all there's to it. But what really happens and what helps with this, again, it takes gravity away from that joint. So it slightly opens the joint up a little bit while you're standing. So it allows the viscosupplementation, the gel, to go throughout the entire knee joint while you're going through the visco series. All right, so get as many patients as you can that to wear these when it's appropriate. Okay, we're not gonna give it to you if you don't need it or if you're just not gonna use it. The visco series, the gel injections, last 6 months, typically. Medicare says you can do the series twice in a year, and you only do an arthrogram once. So we'll check the integrity of each one of the knee joints, make sure it's there, and then if you come back every 6 months to get the series of five injections, you won't have to repeat the arthrogram unless there is a serious injury in between. One last thing. We are here to serve you and help you, okay? I want to be available to you. So you can reach out to me directly for a free phone consult and we'll chat about this. We'll see what have you done in the past, what's worked, what hasn't, what are your expectations. And if I can't help you directly, I promise you I will get you to somebody that can. And if it's just too far for you to get here, I'll do my best to find you somebody closer as well. So I'm here with my assistant Tony. He was going to take any questions because I can't see the phone from here with my old eyes. Do we have any questions? No questions. All right. Well, listen, email me at terrapincare@gmail.com. Call the office at 301-220-1930 or respond to us on Facebook. Set up a free phone consult. I look forward to serving you, helping you, and answering all of your questions. And if, in the coming weeks, we'll talk about what we do with that centrifuge in the back for PRP. What's the difference between stem cells and fetal tissue matrix? Why is it so expensive? Does it work? Is it worthwhile? I'll just say this, not to be a spoiler, we want to help patients utilize their healthcare benefits first. Deductibles have gone up, copays have gone up, it's expensive, all right? We try to get patients to try things first that's covered by health insurance before we get them to dip into their savings to pay for something that's $500, $3,000, $5,000 in some cases out there in some clinics. So, reach out to us. Let us be your pain management advocate. And it's been a pleasure. Have a great day.